Okay, we're going to go through some automation settings now, is what they call it. And so under the gear here, accountant settings, and we go down to the advanced tab and scroll down to automation. Okay, so the first one here is prefill forms with previously entered content. Now the little help button says this is on customers, vendors, and employees. I can't fully get it to work on customers. Maybe it would work on more simplistic things than on invoices as an example, but it does work on expenses pretty well. So if I come in to my expenses here and I add a new transaction, like a new bill, what this is going to do is when I choose the vendor, it's going to default fill in for me the categories, right, which are your accounts, as well as the items, the quantity, the rate, the amount, right? And so here also it's picking up the amount that we had on the bill the last time we paid this particular vendor. So when is this helpful? I mean, if you have, first of all, if you can't remember, right, consistency is so key in accounting. If you can't remember, where did I categorize it last time I paid Sam's parts vendor, right? Where did I put it last time? Having that turned on helps you to have that consistency by filling in some of those fields. So it's definitely a great thing to turn on. However, if you split it out to multiple lines and you need to, you know, clear those lines every single time, it can be, you know, quite intrusive. So be careful when it's turned on too, because if you set some items, right, I'm on the screen right here and I just see categories. I don't even notice that I've actually got some items showing up down there defaulted in, so just have awareness, of course. Okay, so the next setting is coming down here into advanced, automatically apply credits. So this one can get a little bit scary, and the same thing is down here, automatically apply bill payments, because basically in the system it's going to pick up and decide for you where we want to apply payments that have been previously received. So like, let's say a customer pays you and you know, they ahead of time, so you didn't put any transaction in, but I'm going to go ahead and receive a payment. I'm going to create a new customer in here, call it JoJo Shop, and just say save. Of course, you want to put in more information than that, but then down below here, right, it gives me a warning, hey, we don't have any open invoices. That's okay. I'm just going to say I received down payment of $2,500 and say save and new. So it's going to save it as a credit against their account. So when I come in here and I look at my customers, right, and I see JoJo Shop, there's negative $2,500 in there. Now let's say I finally get around to doing my invoicing, or you can see the next setting that we're about to have too, where it automatically creates invoices for you. So JoJo Shop in here, we have the invoice coming in. I'm going to select, we did some hours work with her, JoJo, and you know it was $8,000. So then when I say save here, you're also going to get the warning about classes, but it shows a pop-up. You can choose not to show this again, but what it says is, hey, you had an existing credit for $2,500, so we just applied it to this invoice. So that's great. If that's how your business is run and that's how things should happen, that's wonderful. If JoJo had like 7 different invoices with us and the system was default applying it to the oldest invoice, right, but JoJo said it, she wanted this one applied to the newer invoice, that's where you want to make sure that those things get turned off. Okay, so just have awareness. Awareness is key. So let's go down in here. I kind of talked about it a second ago, but the other setting in here is automatically invoice unbilled activity, which sounds scary. What do you mean? When are you going to do it? How often? So unbilled activity are things like time cards that have gone into the system that we have marked as billable, expenses that we put in the system, credit card transactions, checks, bills that we have put in as billable that need to get billed through to the job. So when you enable this, this is quite cool, actually, quite cool. So it says automatically create the invoices for these unbilled expenses. If you struggle to make sure that you have billed for all the things, right, that can be something you want to make sure that we're taking advantage of. However, when it creates it, you have to be aware, right? You have to have some kind of review. Make sure you have some kind of review before it goes out to the client. So automatically create invoices and don't notify me. I don't recommend that one. Automatically create invoice and notify me or remind me to create invoices. if you can get to the automatically create invoices and notify me, this is the best case scenario in my mind because automation is great. However, you need to make sure that time cards are reviewed, right? You don't need silly notes going in on the time cards, that the expenses are reviewed in some way or form so you don't bill a client for things that you are not supposed to, or you bill a job for something that was for another job accidentally, right? So you just have to make sure to feel comfortable with this automation that you have some checks and balances on the other side for everything that's going to be flowing into there. So let me say how often, daily, weekly, monthly, yearly. If you are going to do it, daily is pretty intense. That would be a lot of invoices for your customers, but maybe they require that, right? Most people do it either weekly, right, like every 2 weeks as an example, or they'll do it monthly on the 1st or the 15th or something like that, right? So if you choose weekly, we can say every 2 weeks, every 3 weeks, every whatever, on Mondays, on Sundays, on Saturdays, right? So what's the time frame? Monthly, you know, I can say on the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, or last day, right? Or I can say it on a particular day, on the 16th, every 2 months, every 1 month. So some pretty cool schedules in here. You can say yearly, every year on August 20th. It's pretty random, but there you go. Okay, and if you bill yearly, that's quite scary, right, to build up all those expenses ahead of time. Hopefully you have a retainer so that you're not cash flow negative for all that time until you bill. All right, so pretty cool stuff there with automation. Again, really great, but you have to have make sure you have checks and balances on the time card entry screen. Then the last step here is the automatically apply bill payments. It's very similar to the invoices here. So if I have a credit for a vendor on file and then I go put in the bill, it's going to automatically apply that credit to the bill. This one is most commonly turned off, right? Because your creditors, your vendors, they're going to apply the credit in the way that they choose. And so you generally have to follow the way that they choose. They apply it to the, you know, the newest invoice that they sent over to you, the newest bill that they sent over to you, and not the oldest one, as an example. So you just have to really be aware. Most of our clients have this one turned off so that we don't apply a vendor payment to a bill or a vendor credit, right, to a bill that is the incorrect bill to apply it to. Okay. All right, so those are the automation steps and setup.